Previously on Survivor.
Are you gonna bring Terry into this?
The thing is, I don't know how much to trust Terry.
Paluke, Victoria, and Zach cemented their alliance, but Zach and Terry kept a tight two of their own.
Which one do you want to go with?
And Zach built on his power on his tribe when he found the hidden immunity idol.
There we go, right here.
After Rafiki lost yet again, Kanae tried to convince Eric and Marissa that it was wise to finally vote out Sabrina.
Voting off Sabrina is going to help us win more than voting off Maria.
But nobody budged, and after a 3-3 tie, Kanae flipped his vote.
Sorry, I tried to help you.
Sending Maria packing.
Maria, the tribe has spoken.
12 are left, and only one can claim the title of sole survivor. Who will be voted out tonight?
I feel fine.
Yeah.
but, you know, until we win one, I'm not going to be satisfied.
So, right.
You
know, like,
I really wanted to keep Maria so we can keep a leverage just in case Eric had too much power, but I had to cave because it was a tie. I wasn't going to let a double tie happen.
Yeah. Alex is pissed. Did you hear him after Maria got voted? He goes, well, fuck.
Yeah, I heard that.
I kind of expected she was going to get voted out because I knew from experience that Eric could not be trusted in the least.
The numbers were already against him regardless of what the vote was. Even if Maria wasn't voted off, the numbers were still
He tried so hard. Like, he totally thought I was voting Eric.
Yeah.
He thought everyone was voting different people, like, to be honest.
Marissa and Eric had my back. They voted for Maria. Part of me felt kind of bad because, you know, she wasn't there at the challenge. But then the other part was me like, yeah, I finally got rid of Maria because, you know, I've had a grudge against her since, like, the second day.
Up to now, we've been feeling really cohesive as a tribe. I feel like we've been able to bond a lot through our challenges since we've been doing well. We haven't really criticized each other. We've been really supportive. And, you know, as a team, we've been feeling really good as a team.
Very feeling.
Do you think this is happening, right? No.
If it's going to be a two-person final, then, like, it's obvious that Katie's Harry's second.
The fact that her relationship is at this point where she slaps him 10 times in the face, I don't really care at all.
So, I'm quite obviously the third man, and Zach's the fourth, so I'm not gonna settle for third. I'm gonna take out first and second, best I can. Obviously, like, Harry can't go to the merge. Love him, but he can't go to the merge.
He's too good,
yeah.
Holly's a strategic player, so I like being on her side. I feel like she's being straightforward with me right now, and that's where I need to be, because she doesn't really have any connections with people, and the people I want to get out, she wants to get out. We see the game the same way, and I appreciate that. Point blank. And she's also so nice. She really is.
And then, what if we could get all the girls to band together and slowly but surely pick off all the guys?
Yeah, I was just... We're the same person. I was literally just thinking that. I was like, all these guys think they have it in the bag. They think we're the weak ones. But if, when we get to the merge,
if we get Marissa
and Sabrina and talk about girl power, we get them on our side, girl, that'll be me, you, and Victoria making it to the final three if we can get all the guys out.
I trust Paluke. The most outside of the Katie and Harry, I'm pretty sure they're not going to turn on me.
Even if they think, oh, they're going to go against us, we'll be like, well, there's four of us and there's three spots at the end.
Is there three spots at the end? Because last season it was only two.
Let it be us. We deserve it.
But outside of them, I would say Fluke, just because she seems very like serious about what she wants right now. And it's very similar with what I want.
Get to hunt it. Get to hunt it. Break.
Okay. Also, who else was asked by one of them to throw this game? Was anybody else asked?
Yeah, I was.
Okay. Yeah, we were asked to throw the game. That means that they don't have faith in themselves.
By whom?
Multiple. About four of them came up to me.
All right, I'm going to go up to them and whisper in their ear, do you want to throw this one too? Because you've been throwing all of them. Be like, oh, did you get the letter where I asked to throw it, or are you just doing that on your own? Guys, quiet!
All right, welcome guys to your fifth immunity challenge. You guys ready to get to your next immunity challenge?
Yes.
Woo!
I'm not ready, I want to go home.
First things first, Ollie.
I'd like to have it back soon. It's been in my house for like 3 weeks.
All right, once again, immunity is up for grabs. Team Pupitani, you guys are looking at the new team, Rafiki. Maria, the last one voted out at Tribal Council. Harry, you look shocked.
I'm really shocked right now. I'm really shocked.
Are you?
No.
You're not shocked? Why are you not shocked?
I just figured it was going that way.
Zach, do you think that Maria being gone helps you guys?
Yeah, I mean, she was definitely one of their stronger female characters.
So, this challenge is going to test your physical, your mental abilities, and your teamwork. All three of those should be tested here. So, on your tribe as it stands, you guys each have 10 feet, okay? You guys all have 10 feet that you're standing on. So, you have 10 feet, all right? So you have to go from one sector through those set of cones, all the way through them, with your entire tribe, with your 10 feet. Once you do that, on the way back, you have 9 feet, okay? You have 9 feet to use, so 1 foot has to not be used. After that, you have 8 feet, 7 feet, 6 feet, etc. Okay? Team that wins will be the team that gets the lowest number of feet first. So if you guys end up at the same number of feet, then it's the team that got through that sector first, okay? If you use too many feet at any point, if a foot falls or anything, then your tribe has to go back to the beginning of that sector, not through the whole thing, through the beginning of that sector, yeah. Okay? The tribe that gets the lowest amount first will win. You guys have 30 seconds to strategize. You guys gonna send out one person. Survivors ready, go! Starting off with a straight sprint, everyone's there. Both tribes get across. Now they're hopping, okay! All right, now they got one on the back. All right, they're working on six. Marissa is just on Eric's back. Feluke on Harry's back. Here's five. Sabrina's going, she's falling behind. Can she stay up? They're on back, they gotta go back. Now they're catching up. Both teams through with five, we're dead even. Eric Hobby with Marissa on 1 foot. Can he stay there? His foot's still up. He's still going. He's almost there. And he gets there. They're complete. Complete with four. Here comes Hukatana with their four, but with a different strategy. Victoria carrying Feluke on her back. Holly wheelbarring. Harry and Katie. Katie on Harry's back. This is three. Here they come with three. Kanae hopping forward. Alex is on 1 foot, carrying Sabrina on wheelbarrow. There comes Eric. Can they get there? His foot's still good right now.
You gotta go through your cone. Go back.
Oh, I fall, I gotta go back. Fukutana's gotta go back. Both teams struggling with the three. Harry's glasses are down. Here they come, hopping on 1 foot. Wheelbarrowing. They're still good with 3 feet. Alice gets it this time. Sabrina gets there. Can Eric get there? And Rafiki's good with three.
Jump on my front like a monkey.
Jump.
Hukutana struggling with their three. Harry's carrying two people on his back. And front.
Take your time.
Did they get four? Yeah.
Harry still carrying them. This is impressive. He's almost there. Gets it. They're strategizing for their two. Got a few minutes left. Going for two. Alex and Eric on 1 foot. A long way to go, but they're going. Keep your foot off the ground, Eric. You need this one. You're about halfway there. They go, and they're back, and they're back. Hukutana can't get three. You gotta go back. 3 minutes left. 3 minutes left. If Hukutana cannot get past three, Rafiki will win the challenge. Are they just gonna wait, or are they gonna try to clinch it? Hukutana struggling with the three. They might give Rafiki a win and some hope tonight. Trying to go for three. If Rafiki can get to two, they're gonna clinch this.
You go on the back.
Harry trying to carry three people on his back.
Guys, I can carry someone in half. Come on, I got it. Get up.
I liked it.
Oh shit! No idea!
Under 2 minutes left. Are they gonna give it one more go? Rafiki could pull off a really impressive feat, maybe swing the momentum for their tribe. Alex is on 1 foot, Eric with 1 foot on his back and wheelbarrow. Eric is literally putting the team on his back. Rafiki looking for their first win in a while. This could be the changing moment. And Eric fell. Harry's got two people on his back. He's got Victoria and Holly. Katie halfway there, you can do it, Katie. Dig deep.
You got it.
And Katie falls. A good effort by Hukutana, but Rafiki pulled off the three. They've got 10 seconds. Three, two, one. Rafiki wins immunity.
Yes.
Finally.
For the first time in four challenges, Rafiki wins immunity and Hukutana. It's been a while. Happy to see you again. Hey, I like being with you guys, so. Yeah. Rafiki, immunity, is back in your hands for the first time since week one. You're free. You don't have to see me again this week. Enjoy a few days off.
That felt great. I hadn't had that feeling in a long time, and because we've been at Tribal so much, our tribe is really tight, so it was a good feeling.
It's been so long. I was incredibly relieved for one, because if we had not, there was a very, very good chance that I would have been voted off.
They came by with the idol and they were like, haha guys, like suck it, we're so awesome. And it was kind of just, it sucked, you know, like having them say that to us, that really demoralized us.
They just walked by and they're like, yeah, suck it.
And then Holly was like, classy.
You're really classy.
It's all right, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, because it's going to get to their heads.
I lost three times in a row. Like, not good.
It was surprising, and it kind of angered me the way that they held themselves after that. Okay. But our team, we weren't really bummed. I mean, we were all bummed, but we ended up laughing at them, and I don't know, like, we were still having a good time.
Guys, Eric voted best couple with his twin sister in high school, so if you want to make fun of him for that. No big deal.
Fluke, she's over the top. She's actually ridiculous. Like, there's a point, like, I said a lot of stuff, and I trash talk a ton, too, and I love her trash talk. It's great. It's hilarious. My key with her is just making sure she's so focused.
Oh, you hear from me.
He's never had a girlfriend before.
He's a serious one. Anyways.
If she's not focused, and she's just, like, looking to get the best of her, she's kind of screwed. Like, she needs to, like, make sure she stays focused as she trash talks.
He can see me after this, because it'll be on. I don't think he understands that this is not a game, and I don't take any type of disrespect. He looks at me any type of wrong. He thought it was. No.
He's scary. Like, if she was, like, coming at me mad, I would be a little bit scared. I think I could take her, but I'd be a little bit scared. Just because she's so feisty. She's, like, scrappy. And she will verbally harass the shit out of anyone.
I'm not about that verbal disrespect, but if you're gonna disrespect me on a physical level, best believe I will come for your life and then some. Just because I'm small, I'm right by your jugulars.
I was supporting her idea, not maybe necessarily what she said, but the ideas of her words were, I agreed with.
Don't come for me. I was raised with a brother, and I did taekwondo, and I played soccer with boys. So don't think that you're going to have the best of me, because I will come from behind. I will come from below.
You speak the truth, girl.
And that was going in her spotlight.
I mean, like, I love Luke and all. Like, she's a pretty good friend. But sometimes she just talks too much, you know? And, like, I'm not someone who really expresses that much in front of other people, especially when, like, you don't know how much you can trust them. And I feel like she just says a lot to everyone, and sometimes that might be a bad thing for her, because, you know, then people just see her as this character.
I have something to say.
Can you
just see her
face? You can brighten it.
Okay, we came together a lot more as a team than they did. It's obvious. You can see that by the time we play. Even, like, we're gonna have to let somebody out. It's a fact of the game. It's just gonna be hard, but, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. Unfortunately for them, they're still split half and half. It's a lot easier for them to vote somebody off, because they're not exactly a team.
Katie, if there's ever an interview for Quidditch, you give the perfect, most neutral answer I've ever heard.
I know, I try not to take sides in things. I find it easier in life just to be neutral.
It's the ultimate sports interview, like.
I honestly think that we're a much more cohesive tribe. It's been really nice being able to bond with everyone. And it does suck that now that we've lost, we're gonna lose someone on the tribe.
One, two, three. The truth is, I wanna know what Victoria's opinion on it was, because that's all that really fucking matters.
Whatever happens, we're not gonna be as close anymore. There's no way.
We're pretty close a team, which is why losing sucks, because I generally like everyone on my team.
and we communicate well, and we do all those things well, and we're supportive. Which is what sucks is that we lost, and we have to get rid of someone.
I don't know. I don't even know why we're here.
We have to get rid of. That's all there is to it.
We like sat down, and I guess it was just because there were so many of us, we didn't really want to talk about like what we were really thinking. Everyone was just like, "So Terry," just because he wasn't there.
I think is he Russian?
Yeah, he's Russian.
I understand, but like, I still think
I'm Terry. No, definitely. Like, it's not. You have to balance your things, and obviously he's chosen his friend first. So. I think that right now I'm really the person who's closest to Terry on the tribe, since he has missed a lot of things and he doesn't live in La Plata with a lot of the other people. He hasn't really been active in trying to reach out to people, and I know he's also pledging, which takes up the majority of his time. So in terms of alliances, he's definitely one of my strongest alliance members.
That is the
It's the only fair way to do
it's
it.
It's the obvious choice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. I don't know how he is.
It wasn't a good time for me to be like, or for Luca to be like, Harry, I think we should vote you out. Like, she's not gonna say that. So everyone was just kind of like, Harry, it's obvious. Yeah. And then once we all left, we were like, no, we're not gonna get Harry.
I think the more people you know, the more alliances you have, the better it is. So it's important to pick and choose who you have alliances with. And I think that, I think that I personally picked good alliances.
So,
I look like a mess today.
So we sat down as a team, but it was like, but it's tough to sit down as a team and discuss that stuff because everyone's there. The thing is, Terry's still stronger than some of the players on our team. Like, my ranks, my players, my teams, like me, Zach, Katie, and Holly, the top four, like these are the four people who are like, help carry the team most of the time. And then Faluke comes out of nowhere for some challenges. Like, Faluke is awesome that leaves Victoria. And honestly, Victoria's the nicest person ever, which is the worst feeling in the world right now.
So you and Zach talked afterwards?
Yeah. And I want to try to, like, beat Victoria. Because she's the weakest player on the team. And it's, like, not because she's not a nice person. That's the issue, is, like, once we get down to it. Because Terry's a cool guy, too. Once we get down to it, we got to get rid of we got to get rid of everyone.
The goal is for you and me.
I will say this, Katie is going to the finals with me. Like I said, we'll cross those bridges when we get there. For now, I want to keep my crew protected.
Okay.
Once I finish this, go do your homework, okay?
I am. Do you remember the panic attack I was having last time?
Oh, God.
It's the same class.
I'm sorry.
So Harry, Holly, and I are definitely in a strong alliance. And Harry can kind of pick and choose who he wants to convince, because most, like, our entire team will listen to Harry for the most part.
What are you making?
Tea. Do you want some?
No. Oh. I was just curious. I see, like, ripping and green things. So I was like, oh, you got that wheat?
Ready, guys. Ready.
I personally would want to go after Katie because she and Harry are way too close for me to be comfortable. And I think as long as they're both in the game, neither of them are gonna, like, betray another.
Wait, it's true that Harry and Zach are talking?
Ooh!
I don't even know if it's Zach at this point.
I told you I don't think we can trust Zach, first of all.
Now I'm just, like, very distrustful of Zach because I feel like Zach would be very willing to vote with Harry in the Quidditch.
I know everybody wants to send Terry home, and I understand that'll, like, keep us together and keep us happy, whatever. But at the end of the day, I know I can beat Terry, and I know you can beat Terry, and we can all beat Terry. So why would we send him home? I think we should send home Katie because, not because she doesn't put up a valiant effort, but she's strong competition for the both of us.
Definitely.
And if we send Katie home, Harry has no numbers.
Like, if Zach and Faluke and Terry all voted with me, we'd be fine. But the thing is, I'm having doubts because I don't think they'll all vote with me.
If we keep losing, we'll have the numbers on our team. And we'll stay. But if we get rid of Terry, we will no longer have the number.
Yeah. Honestly, I think Zach knows a lot more than he wants to tell people. And I think he wants to play with alliances, which I totally understand. That's a great strategy to go for. But being in an alliance with him means that I can't trust him at all.
Faluke came to talk to me earlier. And she wants to vote out Katie. then I think that that's a fine plan. But if we all turn on Harry and Katie, so if it's a 5-2 vote and Katie goes home, Harry is gonna freak out.
So Holly agrees with us.
Really?
Interesting.
You didn't
think I would? No, not at all.
Well, I know
Harry is such a threat. Harry's like, I love Harry. Like, he's a great guy, but if we get
but
to
this
merge,
is competition.
Yeah, if we get to the merge, he's just
gonna,
like,
destroy. So why not
take out Harry?
Harry's a dog. He's a dog that will run circles around us, but if you lock him in a room, he will just run circles in the room.
This is going way over
my head. If you lock the door, then the dog will tire itself out. Do you know who holds that key? Katie. We get rid of the person with the key who can unlock the door. She's the smarts. Unlock the door. She's no longer there. He stays in the thing. He's
or maybe she already unlocked it and he's already out.
However, we still want him to fight hard for our team,
but,
and we want to have his inside data.
Because
Holly.
If Katie gets voted out and I flip on them and they realize, like, there's only two
votes
on their side. If I vote with them and all four of you vote against us three, it's like I'm still, like,
with them.
Gonna
vote
so he's not going to freak out as much. You know what I mean?
But
he's gonna
we want to take the chance that you're not going to vote with us, which you are. You're going to vote with us. But
are you, though?
For who? For Katie?
For Katie.
Well, I want to hear the rest of this. Yeah, I mean, according to our plan.
Okay.
The thing is, if we vote out Victoria, the problem is that the Quidditch Alliance has the majority. But the problem with voting out Katie is that she's one of the stronger girls. So we'll have to make that decision.
Yeah, but see, Harry trusts me, so I should also vote for Terry.
No, because if you vote for...
Yeah.
Wait.
No.
If you vote for Terry and you vote for Terry, that's two.
Yeah, they only have two for Victoria or you.
And we could just
Terry,
say...
You and Victoria vote for Katie.
I'm leaning towards Victoria only because I think Feluke would get over it.
Look at his face! It's so
untrustful! You're like always smiling and scratching! You're smirking!
It's just
freaking
my
me
face!
Out.
I don't know, it's just like, when we told him, he's just always smirking, and it's just like, makes me like, question like, if he's like, playing around with us, or if he's like, really into our plan.
Alright, well then, if you guys, I'm in.
And because, if you think about it, if there's a final two, I don't know if there's gonna be two or three, Harry's gonna pick Katie.
They have a hierarchy. We have an equal partnership. We are the CEOs of this alliance. Then Terry is a worker child. He is on the factory floor, and Victoria is his supervisor, and we are the partners of this company. So if you want to be loyal, and cross me if you dare. But be loyal. You can take your chances with Team Quidditch. Minus Holly, or you could be a part
minus
of
Holly.
I guess he doesn't trust me, which I can totally understand, but I'm totally for this plan, but I don't know if he thinks I am.
I'm still freaking out.
You're the one pointing scissors at me, okay?
Guys, okay.
I feel pretty confident going tonight, but honestly, I have no idea. Like, I trust Katie, and I know Holly will never vote for me, which is huge.
Super nervous about tribal today. Don't know what's gonna happen, and hopefully my ducks are in line. If it goes according to plan, this could be a game changer tribal.
I'm kind of interested to see how tonight goes. I'm not even 100% sure with myself right now, even though tribal's in like an hour.
I do not feel good tonight. I'm not looking forward to this at all.
Alright, are you seriously gonna go with this?
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm trusting you, you're freaking me out.
I don't... Are you?
Yes, I am.
Luke and Victoria. I feel like I don't want to betray them, but on the other hand, it might have to be done. I mean, we are the minority in this team, so I don't want to be on the minority when it comes to the merge. Although they are a stronger alliance with me. But do we really want to be found out so soon, is the question.
Don't! See, I can't
trust
you now.
You
I can't
me out!
I'm smiling because you're the one who's like walking away like not like...
I don't... Guys, you freak me out. You're freaking me out.
It's gonna be a mess. We'll be right back.
been a while. Anyone want to start off? Yes, not a hard question. No.
Yes, I want to start
off. Okay, Harry. Harry.
I'm
just seeing who wants to take it. You guys won for 3 straight challenges.
Yes, we did.
How did that feel?
It felt real good.
Yeah, I'll take
horrible.
It.
Katie's got it.
It was really great and relieving that we did win 3 challenges in a row and we didn't have to ever go through this for 3 weeks in a row. It was just a great feeling for everybody.
She's my spokesperson.
All right.
I'll take this hand. She gave you the hand. The side hand.
Faluke, for you, how do you feel like the tribe came together during those 3 weeks of pure victory? No losing.
We started out the game and you gave us 5 minutes to get to know each other, and then we switched captains and then you had to re-get to know each other. And I think that everyone's okay, I'm good at this, I'm good at this, I'm good at this. And what we realized through the winning of our challenges is that we're good as a team. We each make up where we have weaknesses, and together we communicate and we... Our formula was the same going into this challenge. Unfortunately, it didn't work, and Eric put his team on his back, and at the same... But we triumphed because we remained a team.
So, Victoria, on the other hand, you guys now lost. All that build-up of victory happens for 3 straight weeks. You might maybe get used to it. Now you lose. How does that feel for the tribe?
I think, obviously, it's very, very upsetting. I think it's just everything didn't really work out the way we wanted it to go, which sucks, and so now we're here, which also really, really sucks.
Fluke?
I felt invincible because I thought our team was the best, and we still are, but now it's we're good. But if they muster up enough, rubbing up their muscles or whatever, that they could kind of compete with us, which is a disgusting thought. But it's good to know. Unfortunately, they probably won't get used to winning.
So, Holly, there's this talk about how it would be disgusting if the other team, were able to beat you guys again. What are the feelings like between the two tribes? Is there animosity?
Yes.
Definitive.
Lots of it.
There are many members of our tribe that have serious issues with members of their tribe and have voiced their opinions very strongly. But as a whole, I think the way they handled their win that they finally had was not classless. Yeah, it was very unclassy.
Well, so how does that, you guys are united against a common opponent. Does that make it harder to vote tonight?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, this is not fun.
So, Katie, how do you vote with this tribe united against someone else? How do you turn against each other?
Okay, well, first, I hope that whoever gets voted off realizes that we love them anyway, and it's just something that we had to do. Figuring out, we want to win again, so we have to vote off somebody who maybe hinders our winning or isn't, the best asset to the team. And it's unfortunate that we have to do that, but we got to think of the team and who's going to give us the best chance of winning.
Terry?
I just want to say I feel like there's a target on my back because I wasn't there for the last challenge. I do apologize for that. I'm sorry. I'll try to make it out of it again. I really wanted to be there for the tribe. I tried my best to get back. It just didn't happen. And it's upsetting that they lost. And I feel like we could have won if I was there. And I'm a big asset to the team. And I promised to be there for every other challenge. And I just want to make my... just make my statement known out there that, I promise to commit to this team.
So, Harry, did you feel like anyone screwed up last night and that cost you guys the game individually?
The challenge?
Yeah.
No, absolutely not. I mean, we all played as hard as we could. We all went out there and competed and tried to do everything we could to win. We win as a team, we lose as a team.
So, you guys lose as the 6, or as,
seven.
I guess,
technically yeah. seven.
No, as a 6, as the 6 people there, yeah. And Terry's the only one not there, does that put a target on him?
To be candid, I think I'll take that since everyone else's head dropped. Survivor is about effort, not only it's hard. We all have busy lives, we all have things to do, but when you have to, with such a close-knit team, you have to start figuring out where people are, what they're doing, whether they're committed to it, because at the end of the day, you could be really strong and you couldn't show up, but somebody else is there and they're giving the effort that they can give. So that's a factor in deciding. It's not the only factor. And we'll see how it plays out tonight, Austin.
Well, so now you guys vote unanimously last time. So how does that affect tonight's vote, Holly?
I don't know. I actually haven't really talked to many people. I guess I haven't had time except I'm extremely stressed out because of other things. So I'm not really sure how any of this is
going. It's not relevant.
So, Victoria, you guys are talking about factors in the vote. What else factors in?
I think basically really how much you contribute to the competition, because in the challenges, we do want to win as a team. So we want to keep our strongest people around. And as what Katie said earlier, I guess whoever we feel like doesn't contribute the most will probably end up winning.
So is this a group decision? There's no, it's everyone against one person?
I don't know. We don't know. We'll
of course not,
we'll
right?
find it out.
We actually. Katie slapped me 10 times at the diner the other day.
It's like 4 weeks ago.
I know, it's pretty fucked up.
Like a lot.
All right. We can see where the strength and the challenges lies, I suppose. It is time to vote. Let's start off. Who wants to start? Terry? All right.
Damn, this is hard. Victoria. Sorry, girl. Like, you're a great asset to the team, but when it comes down to it, gotta vote you off. Sorry. I hope we can still be good friends.
Okay. I don't really know what's going on right now. I mean, I thought I did, and then now I'm hearing other things, and everything's so complicated. I don't know.
Man, oh man, oh man. Man, I don't want to do this one. Oh, there's a skull here. Hey, little Pete. Daria, you are obviously one of the nicest people I've ever seen. I'm so sorry. But it's your time. So if this goes the way I want.
As you said, Katie, no hard feelings against this person I'm voting for. We cannot let Harry get to the merge. Or even if he does, we can't have him be strong enough. So my vote, obvious.
See ya.
Like Katie said, this is a game, so we have to make our decisions based on, I know everyone's talking about the team, but at the end of the day, they're really actually just thinking about themselves. And if they're not, I am, because I need this hunted. Like she said, like it's not personal, it's just a game. So, oh, I'm supposed to show you. It's a game, so you're supposed to play strategically. Here we go, get ready.
Good day.
If anyone has a hidden immunity idol and you would like to play it, now would be the time to do so. All right. Once the vote's read, the decision is final. The person voted out will be asked to the Tribal Council area immediately. I'll read the votes.
I'm shaking. I'm cold. It's a physical reaction.
Solemn.
First vote. Terry. Victoria. Victoria. Katie. Fifth vote. Katie. Sixth vote. Terry. That's two votes Victoria, two votes Terry, two votes Katie, one vote left. Fifth person voted out of Survivor Terrapin Trials. Katie. That's three. That's enough tonight, Katie. Katie, the tribe has spoken. It's time for you to go. Katie, over there. Over there. Where you voted?
Well, that was a shocker.
It was definitely a shocker, especially I thought my team saw more value in me. Then again, it might be they realize that the merge is coming close and they don't want me a competitor as the merge. I don't really know why. So it's definitely a shock. A little bit disappointing, but I had a fun time here. No hard feelings. Like, I met a lot of great people. I just didn't expect it to end this soon.
All right, guys. Not all votes are as easy as a unanimous vote. There is a lot of division on the tribe. You guys were united. See if you can pick back up together, win some more challenges before you get to the merge. That's it. You guys are free to go. Stay tuned for scenes from our next episode. Next time on Survivor. Harry's shaken after the loss of Katie.
Say this, I'm not happy, Katie. The exact opposite of what I intended to happen.
I just located my phone, broke a bone in my hand.
And Faluke makes a shocking discovery.